Anything else we need to mention? Any other announcements?
Brad?
Yes.
Was able to attend ministry yesterday at Miami County Prison, and there were 3 brand new souls and 17 rededications.
Amen.
And there was only 42 inmates there. So
yeah. That's 3 brand new souls and 17 rededicated. 17. Isn't that awesome? Garfield to come, and Garfield's going to come and share some word with us and lead us in a word of prayer. And so we can get right into our worship. And then we'll also have our ushers to come after Garfield is finished with our prayer. We'll have our ushers to come. We'll take up our morning offering as well.
I try to keep my eye on the pastor, so when I see him moving up here, I can get here at least at the same time he does. But I missed him this morning. I missed him this morning. I want to share with you something from the Word of God. Would you all stand, please, and move on up? Okay. All right. So I think most of you heard me. But hear the word of the Lord now. Stand and bless the Lord your God forever and ever. And blessed be thy glorious name, which is exalted above all blessing and praise. Thou, even thou art Lord alone. Thou hast made heaven, the heaven of heavens, with all their host, the earth, and all things that are therein, and the seas and all that is therein. And thou preservest them all, and the host of heaven worshipeth thee. Praise the Lord. Let us pray. Amen. Lord, as we come to you this morning, Lord, I know there must be others besides me that we've said it is good to be in the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. And Father, for all of those who have come saying, Lord, it is a joy to be here, I pray today that there'll be a double blessing given to them. And Father, for all others with their needs and whatever they have upon their hearts, Father, let them lay it at the foot of the cross today, casting all their care upon thee, because, Lord, you care for us. And, Lord, we thank you for your presence and your blessing today. So, Lord, we commit this service to thee. We commit ourselves to thee, that, Lord, you may work a work of grace in each one of us during this service. Grant to our pastor liberty of the Spirit, that as he speaks, Lord Jesus, we'll see you speaking through him, and we will receive what you have to say for us today, Lord. So we commit ourselves to thee. Give us ears to hear, hearts to receive, and for that we will thank you and praise you. We ask these things in the name of our Lord Jesus. And Lord, it's a joy for us to just pray the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
So you may have seen I have 3 children. You may have seen my older daughter here a couple times. She's real pretty, tall, and long blonde hair. And her name is Elise. And on December 14th, we went to the doctor. Actually, back in April or May of earlier this year, we went to the doctor and we found out that she had something wrong with her heart. She had an extra nerve in her heart that caused the heart to short out. When that bad nerve would send a charge, it would throw off the good rhythm of her heart and override the nerve that's supposed to do that job, tell the heart what to do. And the problem was is that nerve was sitting on top of the good nerve. So the doctors told us it was a very risky procedure because they couldn't burn that nerve off, because they would risk burning the nerve that needed to be there to keep the heart charged and doing what it needed to do. So she had, you know, an overnight heart monitor. She had a 30-day heart monitor. And then eventually, after her wedding, they stuck in an internal heart monitor, a looping monitor, that they could monitor her 24 hours a day to see what was going on. And eventually, she was diagnosed with what's called Wolff Parkinson's White, which is all that stuff I just told you about, that nerve and it not working. And what would happen is that nerve would short out her heart and cause it to do this for anywhere from 2 minutes to 40 minutes. She could not. even at a resting period, just out of the blue, it would happen. So anyway, on the 14th of December, we all went in there to find out the final diagnosis and what can be done and all this stuff and what we were told. When we went in that morning was that, yeah, she has Wolff Parkinson's White, and yet it's very risky, so we can't burn it off, which is what we normally would do. We have to, what they call cryo it, which is free, kind of like freezing a wart, freezing that nerve, and then you have about 2 minutes to unfreeze the good nerve before they have to actually put a pacemaker in if something goes wrong. So it's kind of a risky procedure. And so we went in there, and the doctor told us all this and confirmed it. This is what's going to happen. And you know, he left and told us, hey, so do you want to do that procedure? And I have this doctor in Indy that I really like and I want to use. And we went through all that mess. And he left the room because the nurse had come in and said, you know, Dr. Steinberg can't see your fax. So we need you to take a picture and send it on your phone to that doctor so they could talk about it. So as he left the room to go take care of his fax that the doctor down there couldn't read, I said, you know what, Elise and her husband Cole, I said, let's pray about this. I said, because I'm not settled, and I don't feel that this is, I just feel like we needed to pray, an overwhelming sense that we needed to pray right at that moment. And this doctor that she's been seeing, I don't know, some of you may know him, Dr. Robleski, he's a very, very knowledgeable doctor. He's an electrocardio specialist. He's one of the top in his field, and he'd been telling us all along, and we're talking about multiple EKGs, monitoring results, all kinds of ultrasounds type stuff she'd had done that showed that nerve was right on top of that nerve. So we knew it was there, not a shadow of a doubt. But we prayed. And as he was out taking care of his bad facts and sending a picture and talking to Dr. Steinberg, he comes back in afterwards, after we prayed, and he said, he had this really crazy look on his face, like he just was dumbfounded about something. And he goes, well, I must have made a mistake, because Dr. Steinberg doesn't agree with me that nerve is on top of the other one. He said he thinks it's a little further away. And he said, and I must have made a mistake about that. And said he definitely thinks it's there, but he doesn't think it's where I think it's at. And so I went back and looked at my old records, and I think he's right. And you could tell he was really frustrated about the situation. Not, you know, the many times we've been in there and he told us basically the same thing. Of course, I knew what had happened. And, you know, we gave the glory to God immediately. And then he said, but, you know, Dr. Steinberg says, yeah, she does need to have that removed, but now it's not as risky. So, in heck, we may even be able to burn it off instead of, you know, cryoing, but he still thinks the cryo procedure is in order. And I said, okay. And he goes, but, and I said, well, any chance that she can get it before the end of the year? And the doctor said, well, no, Dr. Steinberg is so busy. There's no way. The earliest that Dr. Steinberg could even, we're talking late January or February at the earliest. And we're like, and I was thinking, well, darn, we've already met our deductible this year. I hate to have it, but you know, that's okay. We'll get it done when we can get it done. And so he said, well, I'll send the nurse in to schedule that, but it's not going to be for a couple months. And we're like, okay. So he left the room and I said, guys, let's pray again. Because you're married now and those bills are yours. and they go, oh, okay, let's pray. And so we prayed again. And I said, Lord, if there's any way we can get this in before the end of the year, make it happen. We had no sooner said, in Jesus' name, amen. And nurse comes in and goes, any chance you guys could do this December 23rd? So I just am here to tell you, God is, he's an on-time God. Yeah. And he does everything. And to top it off, that's not even where the praise ends. The choir already knows this story, but that's not where the praise ends. She had a procedure Wednesday, and Dr. Steinberg had never seen her in person before, so they had to do a test to pinpoint where the nerve was. And it was away, like he thought. And instead of cryoing it, which comes with a small percentage of it growing back and becoming a problem, he was able to burn it off. So it's permanently gone. There's nothing to worry about anymore.
Man. Hallelujah.
Very, very thankful. So, and the final praise with that is my other daughter also had an abnormal EKG with the same issue a couple months ago. And she had a good one and a bad one. And this Dr. Robleski had said he really wanted Hope to see Dr. Steinberg for a second opinion. Well, Dr. Steinberg was doing the procedure when saying, me being the outspoken, meek, humble person I am, I said, any chance you could look at Hope's records and let us know what you think? Do we need to schedule an appointment for you to come see her? And he went and looked at her and he said, I just want to assure you, I went and looked at her stuff. She's fine. No need for her to come in. So yeah. God is good and faithful, and I'm sorry I took so long, but I just want to share that with you this morning.
Amen.
All right. Now let's sing. So stand to your feet. So if you didn't have a reason to praise the Lord with me. Share my testimony, because God is good and He is an on-time God.
Joy to the world.
Joy to the world, Savior. been asking God, they've been praying, and they've been asking God, and they're praying, and they've been asking God, and they're not seeing anything. I'm going to tell you what. If you want something God to move,
yes,
you're going to have to stop doing what you were doing. You got to do it. You got to sacrifice. Whatever it is that's keeping you back from fully experiencing the anointing and the abundance of Christ. I'm telling you what. There's power in the anointing. If you're not walking in the anointing, if you're not living in the anointing, you can wait and wait and wait and wait. And it's not going to happen because healing happens in the anointing. And if you want God to move in your life, you are going to have to give it up to Him. You're going to have to just surrender it all to God. Surrender it all to God. All of it. And I can't tell you why God answers prayer here and why God doesn't answer the prayer here. But I'm going to tell you what, I know the anointing has power. And you have to know that the answer isn't always what you think it should be. I'm telling you, you need to quit getting mad about having to wait. And you need to start getting happy that you have the anointing. Sing that chorus again. Thank you.
Our rest in Him in every way. His presence brings that anointing and that balm and that healing that we need. And I believe that He wants so much from us this coming year to seek Him more than we ever have, more than you ever have. Study His Word, seek Him out, spend time listening to Him. Look, we spend a lot of time petitioning, don't we? I do it too. And I don't think there's anything wrong with asking the Lord. But He wants us to spend time loving Him, letting Him love us, letting Him speak to us. And that happens in the presence. It happens in the presence of God, doesn't it? Oh, praise the Lord. Come give it to Him.
This has been bursting in my heart, so I'm going to give it to you if I can control myself here. Hear the word of God. Hear what He says in the epistle to Ephesians. For this cause I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that He would grant you according to the riches of His glory to be strengthened with might by His Spirit in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend and apprehend with all saints what is the breadth and length and depth and height, and to know the love of Christ that passeth knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God. And unto Him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus, for He is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Unto Him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you. I'm melting your hands, it's overwhelming.
Something I want to say today. You all know I had this soldier. operated on about a month ago. I've had two brothers that's had shoulder surgeries. And they said, man, you're in for a lot of pain. He says, it's going to hurt. My doctor told me, he said, now, Gene, he says, when that block wears off, you're going to have pain. And he says, when you start therapy, you're going to want to slap them sometimes because it's going to hurt so bad. Well, I did what he told me to. I started that pain medicine as soon as I got home. When the block left off, I don't know. All I know is I serve a good God today because I can use my arm, my shoulders, and I've never had any pain with it. That's the kind of God we serve. Now, everybody that's had these surgeries, they all tell me the same thing. But for some reason, and I don't know what that reason is yet, that God has allowed me to go through this without any pain. And I want to give Him glory this morning. I want to give Him praise this morning. And I want to thank Him for being in this service this morning because He's here. He's ministering today, and He's not done yet.
Reach out and touch the Lord as He passes by. You'll find He's not too busy to hear your heart's cry. He's passing by this moment.
Yes, He is.
Your need to supply. Reach out and touch Him. And I found in my heart that there's people that say, well, that's probably not for me. And one thing is say, well, I wonder if people ought to do that. Ask the person who was healed if they ought to do it.
Amen. Hallelujah. How many knows He's in the house today? Amen. Amen. Praise God. He's doing a work. And you know, He's not finished. He's not finished. Just keep your hearts open to Him. Let him open your heart. Amen. Let Him open your heart. Praise the name of Jesus. I want to tell you something. Everybody in here, I love you very, very, very much. And Jesus loves you very, very, very much. If at all possible, don't leave this church without being filled with the Holy Ghost. You need the Holy Ghost with evidence of speaking in other tongues. And if you don't have, and if you're not filled with the Holy Ghost, you ought to be up at these altars and you ought to be saying, Father, fill me with your love and the Holy Spirit so that I can do service for you. It's all about the service. It's all about doing something for Jesus. And you cannot do your work unless you are prepared by the Holy Spirit. And He will prepare you. He will tell you what to say. He'll show you what to do. He'll lead you who to talk to. He'll lead you in every way that you need led. Don't leave these doors without being filled with the Holy Ghost, if at all possible. If you can't receive today, then don't stop seeking it. Ask the Lord every moment to fill you up with the Holy Ghost until your faith can become such that you can receive it, and He will fill you. You'll be a new person. You'll be like you were reborn again. Remember how good it felt to be born again by Jesus' blood and His sacrifice? When you're filled with the Holy Ghost, with evidence of speaking in other tongues, and you know that you have that down in with your spirit, telling you and showing you what to do, there's nothing you can accomplish. He will lead you into all truth. And He will take care of you and do for you what nobody else could do. Seek the Holy Ghost. Don't leave here without receiving it. Please don't. Please don't. Please don't. Praise God. Letting the Holy Spirit just fill you up. Amen. You know, I tell you, and that's so important in the church. It's a lost. It's lost in a lot of churches. Just going to be honest with you. You know, we think we can build our churches on programs and all this stuff, and if we do this just right and that just right, they'll come. They're not going to come without the Holy Spirit. It's the Holy Spirit that's come to empower us, every one of us, as individuals. Amen. To be led by Him. That's what it's about. You know, this is a special day. God has come in here with His presence, and He's filling the hearts of these people. Now, who wouldn't want to be a part of that?
Amen. Hallelujah.
In this troubled world we live in today, they'd look at us today and they think we're crazy. But you know, when Jesus walked, they thought He was crazy. But He was the one. And He's still the one and only, church. You say, well, I don't understand. Well, get in your Bible. That's the problem. It won't do you any good having dust on it, thinking you know what you know in it. Because if you think you know, I got news for you, you don't. And you need to know it. You need to really search and get in there and let God's Word live in you. I've preached it. Let God's Word live in you. Let Him live. Let Him live. Because it's in a mess. That's why we got all them candidates on the Republican side. We got so many of them. We're in a mess. And ain't a one of them can fix it. The elephant or the donkey. They're not going to fix it. Are you in the house? If you're waiting for one of them candidates, think they're going to change this situation, I got news for you. Either side is not going to change it. God's Word's already fulfilling it. It's right here. It's in the hearts of each and every one of us who believe. Amen. And He wants to fill the Spirit because He wants to direct us. He wants to direct each and every one of us. Amen. How many knows He's a healer today? He's a deliverer. And He wants to fill you. As the brother said, He wants to fill you with His Spirit. He wants you as close to Him. Man, what a way to close out the last Sunday of 2015. Going into a brand new 2016. Amen. Hallelujah. Whatever it holds and however long we have, He's coming. And when the rapture comes, you don't want to be sitting in your seat, do you? I've always told people He'll probably, for our area, He'll probably come on Sunday morning. Just to see who's left in the churches who think they've really got something. He's coming back for a people that's not thinking about what they've got, but a relationship with Him that's full of love. Not only for Him, but for those around you. Amen. Man, we've had Brock turned his heart over to Jesus this morning, didn't you, Brock? Amen. Love you, Brock. Brock is the manager of the Taylor Girls High School basketball team, and I got connected with Brock by helping coach and connect with him, and he texted me last night and said, where's your church? And I kept trying to tell him where it was at, and he finally just came out and said, can I get a ride with you? I said, yes, you can. Amen. And I'm grateful for that today, aren't you? But God's not done here today. He just started. We're opening ourselves up to Him, and what the brother said, we want to be filled with His Spirit. Why would you not want to be filled with His Spirit? I can't understand somebody going out there, did you hear what he said? Yeah, I heard what he said. I'm taking it to heart. Because we all need to be filled with His Spirit. Why would you not want what God wants to give? Why wouldn't you? Everybody will sit around the table and talk about CNN, those candidates. Amen? They're not the answer. They'll never be the answer. But He is. He's the answer. He always has been, and He's going to be. And He's coming. Is He not coming? Are you ready for Him? Amen? You know, He's here. I don't know. This is different. The Lord is just, He's here in the house. And I'm just here to love on him and let his presence just fill this place. And I just don't want anybody to leave shorthanded. Amen. Praise God. You don't want to, when you go to the grocery store, you want to make sure you get everything you got. Amen. And take it back home with you, right? That's the way that ought to be in church every time you come. You don't want to leave shorthanded. You want to make sure you got everything that you stand in need of with the Lord in His presence. To come with your whole heart and worship Him. And if you worship Him with your whole heart and give Him everything, and that's the reason why you're here, you won't be shorthanded. Amen. You won't leave shorthanded. But you'll leave filled up. Amen? Hallelujah. He's here. He's here. Just open your heart to Him today. Will you? Just keep opening your heart to Him. I don't know when we're finished. I don't know. But He's here today. He is here right now. He's speaking out. There may be another need here or several. Maybe there's things on your heart, but you're a little bit afraid to step out. I'm going to tell you something. You take that step, God's already took it with you. He's already taken it with you. I know what it's like to take that step. It's the greatest step of my life. Changed my life completely. Amen. It'll change yours. Maybe there's something, and maybe there's someone here still what Heather talked about earlier that's holding on to something for a long time. God's here to take that for you. He's here to relieve you. He's already answered prayer around this place. Those that's come and prayed at this altar, those that's come and prayed for different things of healing and deliverance. There have been healing, there have been deliverances. God has just done it. Salvation, everything's happening here this morning. Isn't that awesome? My message title is Let Your Request Be Made Known to God. It's in the bulletin. It's in the print. You can read it. That's what it was. That's what it was going to be. I think we're doing that. God knew before I did, didn't He? I was all wrapped up in the scripture and everything, and God said, I'm already taking care of that. I've already jumped the gun. Most people would say, it's disqualification, but not in here. Amen. It's just the beginning of great things. I believe, church. God's ready to do something in this house. Do you believe that? He is. There's things happening and things going to more happen. And Lord, you just take this thing. Amen. And that's what's really tough, to let go and let God in it. But He's here. Yes, Sister Jen.
I had manic granddad, and I did have cancer, but it wasn't real bad. But I went to, and it's here, and it never come back. It's been a long time, and I've been praying and praying, and I love the Lord.
Amen. It's healed. Amen. Situations and testimonies today, and whatever you are going through, probably somebody's been there. Somewhere along the way. God has a way of doing things, doesn't He? Has a way of doing things. And I think as we close, I don't know, Heather, if you had anything or not. But, you know, whatever there is, I just don't want to see anybody leave here empty. Go ahead, ma'am. Of this body, just this body right here, and just think of all the other bodies God is dealing with. Amen. But just right here, look what God is doing. Amen. Hallelujah. I'll tell you what, this is great, and that's why I said I just don't want anybody to leave empty-handed, short. He's here, and this is your opportunity. Take advantage. You know, when the Lord left, the last thing, one of the last things he was telling his disciples, it's to your advantage that I go. And you know how hard that had to be when they were walking with him. Able to take him by the hand and walk that journey together. But he said, it's to your advantage that I go, because if I don't go, then the Holy Spirit won't come. And the Holy Spirit has come to live in you, to guide you, to direct you. See, that's where churches build. They build on what Jesus instructed. Are you in the house? Are you really listening to what I'm saying? But he said, I must go that your helper can come. And the Holy Spirit is your helper. It's there to help you. It's there to walk with you. It's there when it feels like no one else cares. I'm there to tell you, he does. And it'll be there when things really seem empty and things really get hard and it gets difficult. I'm there to tell you, the Holy Spirit will be right there. Touch your heart and open you up and help you. That's what it's about, church. It's simple but yet so powerful. He's an all-awesome, mighty God. He's worthy to be praised and to be glorified. And what a way to close out 2015 to get ready for 2016 is what he's doing here today. I'm hungry for him. I want more of him than I could ever imagine, even more. Because the time is nearing. Your hope's not in the world. Your hope's in Jesus. You need to understand that. We can live in denial all we want to, but that won't help you any. You need to know the real facts. And the fact is, Jesus loves you and he's coming for you. He's coming for you, and he wants to fellowship with you. He wants to love on you, and he wants to make the best for you as long as you've got here on this earth. And only he can do that. He's the only one that can. Nobody else can. Not even your mama, children. Are you here? As good as they can't make it for you. Only Jesus can make a difference and help you when you really need that help. Are you here, Jan?
Thank you, Father God, that you've never given up on me. I thank you for all that you've done in my life. I praise you because you are worthy. You are a holy God, Father God, and help make us a holy people to serve you and to worship you and give you the glory and the honor and the praise that you so deserve. I bless your precious holy name and thank you again for all that you've done in my life.
Amen. As we close out, as we can stand, can somebody get Philippians 4:6 on there for me? I'd like to share that as we close, and I want you to think about this because it really relates to what God is doing here today. It just, you know, it's what I was going to close out with in the message and this scripture, if they can find it. Philippians 4:6.
I'd like to share something with you. God is greater and bigger than death, hell, and the grave. You know, our mother went home to be with Jesus, and I'm really happy, but I really miss her, and I have a hard time with it. The last month and a half, we've had 4 family members overdose on drugs, 3 kinds of drugs. 2 of them died. But the good news, the Lord gave him another chance. He brought him back. And God's bigger than drugs. He's bigger than your sorrow. He's bigger than death. He's conquered death, hell, and the grave. So I encourage you, no matter what, and we've gone through a lot in the last year, and I'm not going to share it with you. Well, last 5, probably. But I want to encourage you, call upon him because he hears you. He will answer you. And And when you have a need, He's the need meter.
I thank God for this service this morning. It may seem weird to us, but it's not weird to God. And it all started because of obedience of Heather. She made this statement today that somebody had been fighting something for a long time. And I thank God that we've got a pastor that follows the leadership of the Holy Ghost. He mentioned a while ago about the Bible. There's an old song, it's a dust off your Bible and redeem your poor soul. Of all the other books you'll find, there's none salvation whole. And if you want to grow in the Lord this coming 2016, get into that Word and study the Word, and He'll reveal it to you. He'll give you more than what you think you could ever understand. And I'll tell you, friends, I am glad that I was here this morning. This is not an odd service. It's a service that God just come in just like a mother with a hen and just bathed us this morning with his presence and with His Spirit. And I'll tell you what, we're ending out 2015, but look out 2016. God's going to take this church to a higher level, and when He gets to that level, He's going to one higher and one higher. And when 2016 ends up, I look for this place to be full, and we'll have to start talking about rebuilding again. And I'll tell you what, God is an awesome God. He's a good God. He's a God that will take care of us. He's a God that supplies our needs. He's a God that does everything that we need to do to go ahead and walk with Him and talk with Him and do this, just bask in His presence. And I don't want to preach this morning, but I've got this in here and I've got to get it out. And God, He just takes care of us. I've went through an awful lot this year. My wife's went through an awful lot. But God has seen us through. God has supplied the needs that we need. And everything's all right between me and my God. And I love Him this morning and I appreciate Him. And I just want to lift Him up and thank Him especially for this congregation right here today.
Thank you, Gene.
Amen.
That's all I got. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be known unto God.
Amen. Be anxious for nothing. In other words, don't worry about anything. It's not my words, that's the Word of God. You don't need to worry about anything, but what you need to do is, it's prayer. It's simply taking it to God. Amen. By prayer and supplication, asking sincerely unto God with thanksgiving. With thanksgiving. With those ingredients. Then He says, let your request be made known to God. You see, in the fifth chapter of John, there was a man lame for 38 years. He wasn't born that way. Doesn't say he was born that way. Matter of fact, he had a life, and Jesus shared that. And not every sickness is cause of sin, but there is some that's caused by sin. And in that man's life particularly, it was. He said, what are you talking about, preacher? He said, well, Jesus met him back in the temple after it was over. He didn't know Jesus. And he told him, he said, listen, you know, now that you've been made whole, go and sin no more unless the worst thing come upon you. Jesus simply looked at him and said, hey, do you want to be made whole? Man been laying there 38 years. Jesus knew his condition. He knew his condition. See, Jesus knows you. He knows where you are. Doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. The fact is, Jesus knows you. And he looked at that man. He said, do you want to be made whole? Well, the man didn't know him, and he's making all kinds of excuses. I can't get in, and someone else beats me to it. And his physical condition was as bad as his spiritual. His will,
His will was as bad as his ailment. But that all changed to a word. When Jesus said, just rise up. Amen. Jesus said, rise up and walk. Take your bed and walk. The man who had laid there 38 years making all excuses in the world, couldn't get in that pool to be healed, suddenly by a word, his will changed, and through the power of God, he was able to get up and walk on the Sabbath day. That caused problems, but Jesus wasn't there to just bring peace to everybody. You know, he liked doing things differently and stirring up things a little bit. Jesus has stirred some things today. But he's here. Doesn't change the fact of who he is and what he is. And he's here for you right now. As we close out and sing this song that we're going to sing together as we close. If you have a need, don't leave it. Don't leave it there. Bring it to the Lord. Amen. Come to Jesus today. Will you do that? Let's do it. Let's sing a song. Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the
Thank you.
Yield and hit her, and she was in really bad condition, and she come through that, but she was still being cared for, and the ones that were caring for her had dropped her in some way, and she went for the worst again, but now she's bouncing back, and she's doing some better. Is that right, Brock? Breathing on her own now again, so that's good. And her, what's Ashley's last name, do you remember? Dunham. Ashley Dunham. So we want to lift that girl up in our prayers, amen, continually to lift her up as well. And this has been a great day, isn't it? Enjoy this day and whatever's on your heart. If God's still something in you, just feel free to call us today. It's okay, amen. I'll be glad to talk to you, pray with you, whatever, or anyone else for that matter. That's what it's all about, isn't it? We just didn't want anybody to be shortchanged today. God's come to fill us all. Amen. And may you have a wonderful day and a happy new year to you. And again, tomorrow night, the men staying at Culver's for the men. And ladies, you ladies can go out somewhere fancier since the guys are going to get hamburgers. You ladies just get together and make sure you take the guy's credit card, all right? When you do, all right? Also, don't forget Thursday night, if you don't have anything to do and you want to come out, Fellowship Hall, 6 o'clock, be a lot of fellowship and games. God bless you. Bye-bye.